about Nitro. This WCW Monday Nitro, 9 p.m. Eastern, on our sister network, TNT, a special triangle tag team match. And we'll be telling you about the six participants in just a moment as we continue here with the action.
Why don't you just tell them now?
Because we're going to go back to our ring announcer, Mr. David Penzer, for the introduction of one of the most dominating tag teams ever in WCW.
Their opponents from 110th Street in Harlem, New York, Booker T, Stevie Ray, Harlem Heat.
Survival was the key word for the Mega Powers. But yes, Stevie Ray and the man Lex Luger, who I say is only out for himself, handcuffed one animal during that confrontation with Sting and Booker T against the Road Warriors. And you talk about the information you just handed us. Well, this right here is the team I'm talking about. Harley Heat is going to be very disappointed about Monday Nitro.
And State Patrol now having their differences, as they always seem to have.
Well, tell them who's in the triangle match. You just told them Harlem Heat wasn't.
The Steiners, the Road Warriors, and the Nasty Boys in a triangle match this Monday night, 9 p.m. Eastern. Wow!
I tell you what, the score is going to be settled, but Harlem Heat surely ringing now in their ear what needs to be done. We're going to talk a lot today about the Flair situation with Luger, talk about the situation now that the Harlem Heat are not in this triangle match. Do they get that shot at the World Tag Team titles? And that big snake of the grass, Lex Luger, Sting's partner, right here. Boy, Harlem Heat starting off to a big bang.
Stevie Ray uncharacteristically starting the match off for the Harlem Heat. And he is manhandling the State Patrol here at Universal Studios. He did nail him. He goes for the one, the true. Buddy Lee Parker comes in and kicks the head of Stevie Ray. Now in comes Booker T.
Yeah, did it in the nick of time, too. But again, Harlem Heat ring positioning is excellent. Brings him over, making numerous tags. There you go. You outweigh the guy, Booker. Nail him.
Booker T proving to be a tremendous partner for Sting at Uncensored. And as we said, they're not going to be in the triangle match at Nitro. They've got to be wondering why they are. It's the Steiners, the Road Warriors, and the Nasty Boys. That's not to say that Harlem Heat won't insinuate themselves process. Oh, man. Let's put it here in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, Christopher Cruz, I got to give kudos for kudos. All given. You know what I'm talking about. I would like to take my hat off to our colleague, the legendary Larry Zbyszko, who opened up this past Monday Nitro with reckless abandon. Still sticking to the point, though, that Mongo McMichaels and Kevin Green don't stand a chance against Arn Anderson, Nature Boy, Ric Flair. I'm going to get into that a little longer, a little later into the pro show this morning.
Well, you know, it's hard to be humble when you're so great.
And speaking of this past WCW Monday Nitro, fans, on behalf of everyone here at World Championship Wrestling, we do sincerely apologize for a couple of occurrences during Nitro. They were circumstances beyond our control, and we hope that you will accept the apology of World Championship Wrestling. Now the collar and elbow tie-up, and Alex Wright is shoved back into the turnbuckle. Manny Fernandez is ready for this young man.
Yeah, he's ready. He wants victory here. This is a big step up for Manny Fernandez, and he's not going to apologize to anybody. Alex Wright better be on his toes, better start getting aggressive now that, he's not a teenage pimply kind of kid anymore.
Teenage sensation.
Whatever.
Teenage sensation. You know, speaking of Nitro, the Giant Dusty will be in action this coming Monday night, 2 hours live from Asheville, North Carolina, defending the WCW World Heavyweight Championship.
Well, we're taking a look at the wonder kid, and Larry the Legend Zbyszko did talk about the situation with him, no longer being a teenager, knowing when to put guys away, knowing what a victory means to a guy here on WCW Pro, right here on TBS this morning, and the other line along them things right here. You talk about news of Nitro coming up. Not only the Great American Bash around the corner, I'm going to talk about that, but I know you got some big news. Can I let out just a little bit of it right now? I won't say the name.
Come on, Uncle Seek in the fleet.
Former World Tag Team Champion going to be at Nitro this weekend. They hadn't been here for a while. I ain't going to say because I know that's your thing, but I just want the people to understand that.
Two of the most popular wrestlers ever.
Ever.
In World Championship Wrestling. Indeed, they
are.
Yeah,
but you know what? They're wrestling Arn Anderson and Ric Flair.
Oh,
they're gonna have about as much of a chance as Dumbo McMichaels and Kevin Green.
Stop it.
That's coming up live and only on pay-per-view at the Great American Bash. You gotta wonder, what if Kevin Green and Steve Mongo McMichael defeat Ric Flair and Arn Anderson at the Bash? How will Flair and Anderson feel then?
Well, I'll tell you what, they have an opportunity to do it. The athletes of today, and these guys are in top shape, top form. Wrestler that I am, Larry, you're right. And wrestlers in the past, I only seen two guys that really took their careers in wrestling after football. One was the legendary Wahoo McDaniel and the big cat Ernie Ladd. The rest of the guys fell by the way as far as football players go.
Yeah, but look at, there was Alex Karras. He thought he was tough.
One time.
Dick the Bruiser had him crying like a baby. He would never get near a ring again. And who was the other jerk?
Yeah.
No, that was another jerk.
Yeah, well.
Dick Butkus.
Yeah.
He tried it, and he got sent back to the showers crying like a baby.
Well, time will tell. These guys are working hard. Mongo, my Michael, my man, my homie, they ready. And you see Manny Fernandez right here taking the best of young Alex Wright.
Yeah, he's going to have a 19-year-old cap in his mouth after that one.
Had a chance as well to speak to the legendary Manny Fernandez, who is wondering how this young man has the gall to use that name. I said, it's his name. That's what he's doing.
There's no legendary Manny Fernandez.
Manny Fernandez, the former WCW one half of the Tag Team Champions of the World.
And who was his partner?
I do not know.
The American Dream Dusty
Rhodes.
Yes.
I knew it. A version of a reverse chin lock there on Alex Wright by Manny Fernandez.
Almost a chokehold there. You got to have that arm up a little bit more.
Oh, man.
That's close, but if Manny can get away with it, he's going to keep the pressure on Alex Wright here.
Another surprise, we're going to see the debut of two young wrestlers here in World Championship Wrestling this very hour, one of whom is a former Olympic medalist.
Yeah, and I tell you what, and I know that he's been training hard. I've seen some tapes of this young man, and he's got a lot to learn, but a real special look at a former Olympian, if you will, right here on the pro.
Well, what weight did he wrestle at in the Olympics?
In fact, he's a former bobsledding champion.
Bobsledding?
Bobsledding has been working out at the power plant, WCW's school for up-and-coming young wrestlers.
You mean this kid just sat in a go-kart?
One, two, and... I don't think it was quite that way.
And went down a hill full of ice. That's his big claim to fame.
Why did
He's
going to
have
it?
A rude awakening.
I'll tell you something else that came out of you talking about the power plant. They took a big step this past Monday Nitro when hardworking Bobby Walker took a victory for the power plant, if you will, and himself right there on Nitro with the legendary Larry Zbyszko was also there with the silver tongue, Tony Schiavone.
Yeah, in fact, a big upset for hard work Bobby Walker on Nitro. Now Alex Wright slamming his elbow. Oh, what was that? A headbutt, I think, on Fernandez. Hurt the lower part of his back. A whole lot coming up tonight on WCW Saturday Night. We'll be telling you about that, as well as more about the Great American Bash. Oh, man, those European forearm uppercuts. Both Alex Wright and Lord Steven Regal traded those uppercuts in their recent match at World Championship Wrestling. Now the whip, and Alex Wright with an elbow.
Alex Wright, I mean, tall kid, about 6'3". He can bring that arm up. He's learned how to use the momentum well. Right there, nice snap. Kind of close to the rope, though. Where's he going?
He's going to go up top here. I want to hit high-risk maneuvers. Don't want to miss this thing. Too much at stake right here this morning on the pro. Whoa!
Bang!
Oh!
And slam. Not a whole lot of weight behind that. One, two, and...
He took too long. He was too close to the rope. Oh, he got him right smack in the jaw.
Well, he's out now. He's out cold now. Moving around just... This is not even rigor mortis. This is just moving around out of reflexes.
Oh, and a beautiful suplex from the waist lock. One, two, and three in a bridge. Alex Wright victorious over Manny Fernandez as we kick off WCW Pearl this morning here on TBS. Still to come, we're going to see, as we said, two debuting young men here in World Championship Wrestling, one of whom is a former Olympic medalist. We'll see Sting in action and a whole lot more in a moment here on the pro.
This portion of W.
Man, you seen the size of Harlem Heat lately?
They're huge, man.
Good God,
man. I know. I tell you, I'm sick of it, too.
So, Sting.
Yep.
What did Luger say?
I'll tell you. Nobody else.
All right.
What did he say you and me joined the Shake Your Booty Tour, huh?
Hey, what's wrong? What's your sign?
Really big.
Better than when
you
told me to remove.
Really big.
Oh, in the ring. As goofy as he is, just took everything wrong and blew everything out of proportion.
Well, that's It is Lex Luger and Sting against the Steiner brothers in what was going to be a match of friends against friends, now enemies. Now enemies.
Yeah, and the giant will defend the world's heavyweight title. You know, Luger is in a situation to wrestle for the world's heavyweight title. And Luger put himself in that situation by being, as I have said on numerous occasions, Larry, I read it different. He is a snake in the grass, and Sting's got to realize that.
Now, I mean, you're spreading rumors. And, you know, that's what's responsible for messing Sting's attitude up. Luger's proven himself to be nothing but trustworthy.
Now, Pat Tanaka with two chops to the throat there on Chip Minton. Chip is the former Winter Olympic medalist in bobsledding for, of course, the United States.
I got an idea. Why don't we team him up with McMichaels and Green? They can all hop in a bobsled, take off down the hill before Anderson and Flair stretch the heck out of them.
Well, the modern-day athlete, when we're talking about football players, we're talking about one Kevin Green, tremendous athlete, very active in what he's doing, and Mongo McMichael keeps himself in tremendous shape. It will be a war, my friend, coming up at the Great American Bash from Baltimore, Maryland on Father's Day. And guarantee you, know you say what you want to, Larry, these two guys are gearing up for a fight.
And you know, you talk about what if Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green are able to defeat Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. Well, another what if Lex Luger defeats the Giant for the World Heavyweight Championship? What is Sting going to think at that point, now that Sting thinks maybe something happened there when he faced the Giant, when that megaphone hit him?
Well, maybe it'll wake him up.
Maybe it will.
And who cares what Sting thinks? It will be Lex Luger's victory.
A cruiserweight title on the line, Rey Mysterio Jr. So much has been heard about him. He's going to face the cruiserweight champion, Dean Malenko. And look at the Great American Bash. And, of course, Falls Count Anywhere. Kevin Sullivan, the Taskmaster, against Chris Benoit. What if they go up in the concession stand? Who knows what's going to happen at the
matter.
Great American Bash?
Falls Count Anywhere. That's right up the Taskmaster's alley. Could happen in the Dungeon of Doom.
And Tanaka flies.
He nailed this, Chip Minton. Bobsleds can't fight back, kid. You're in a different sport here.
I tell you what, this is a fine-looking young athlete. He's got a way to go, got a lot to learn right here, but he's in there with a guy that is devastating when he wants to be or he gets an opening. I'm talking about one Pat Tanaka. Very schooled in the art of self-defense, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, not a very big guy, gives away some size, but Tanaka extremely sneaky in there.
And he has got, looks like a couple of handfuls of hair. Now another chop to the throat. A wide open Chip Minton. Indeed.
Chip Minton, it sounds like you're calling a match for my three sons. Boy, he used his momentum there. He just sent Tanaka sailing.
It was like somebody tripped him. It was like there was somebody over there that wasn't over there. It was like a ghost tripping and knocked him right on his head. He was thrown with so much power into that turnbuckle. Showing power right here. Could this be another upset for the power plant?
Oh, a beautiful drop kick from a standing position. And he does it again, Chip Minton. What a tremendous showing this is for the Olympic medalist. Up and does it again a third time. Wow.
Well, he's got to get him in a position, Larry, as you know, to pin him and cover him. And
yeah,
I don't know if that's going to do it.
Not there.
They didn't know where he was. He got discombobulated from the middle of the ring.
A good look at the fans who are jam-packed the Pearl Arena. Here at Disney MGM Studios. No.
Didn't
Minton
come out.
Jumps up. Oh!
He nailed this kid. He's out.
Welcome to where the big boys play.
Get the bobsled or the gurney. Chip Minton's going to need some help getting out of the ring after that. The thrust kick to the throat.
Forget the bobsled. Just send this kid downhill on a gurney. Same thing.
A whole lot more action to come here on WCW Pro on TBS. WCW Saturday night.
Maybe I shouldn't have given any ideas.
As they get ready for Nitro, the second week of a two-hour Nitro, 8 to 10 p.m. Eastern Time on TNT, and they are going to face the returning former World Tag Team Champions. What a surprise that's going to be. You're not going to believe it. We'll tell you about it a little bit later in the hour. And Disco Inferno now tries to tag up with Billy Kidman.
Billy Kidman, another kid from the power plant, trying to make his name. All them guys, I'm going to tell you what he does for you. When you see somebody that pulled the upset, if you will, as hardworking Bobby Walker did on this past night show, when you see somebody do that, and you've been down in that power plant, for 9, 10, 11, 12 hours a day, and you've been sweating, you've been learning your trade, and you've been waiting to get on right here on TBS, right here where WCW is, where the big boys play, that opportunity is unbelievable. His adrenaline's got to really be flowing right now.
Yeah, a lot of butterflies in his stomach, too, which means it'll lead to mass confusion for this kid. Kidman giving away a lot of size to Disco, who thinks about his hair too much, but has good movement. Oh, hey!
Speaking of good movement there, the scissors, and Billy Kidman looking great against the Disco Inferno. You know, we've talked a lot about Big Bubba shaving half of the head of the Shark. What if on this coming Monday Nitro, the giant surprise opponent is indeed the Shark, and he comes out with half his head still shaved? Is the giant going to want to face a man of 500 pounds that furious?
Well, there's a lot of ifs there. We still got to get to WCW Saturday night, as we know. But with the Great American Bash coming up, it takes me back watching this situation right here of a young guy right here. Just as Larry said, adrenaline flowing, breaking into where the big boys play. The same could be said for Mongo McMichaels and Kevin Green breaking in to where the big boys play right here at WCW.
Oh, break in. You got a couple of big, dumb linemen who go into a huddle without a quarterback. They have no idea what to do. They stand around with their pads on.
I believe that Kevin Green's deal is somewhere around $7, $8 million, so the dumb part is out the window. I believe they're a little smarter than that.
Well, he doesn't even make what
one,
I do.
Two, almost a three count there on Disco Inferno by Billy Kidman. Kidman is looking fantastic now. Watch this. Oh, a modified bulldog right off the top rope. What an original move there by Kidman. And Kidman appears to have hurt himself there.
Yeah, original high-risk move, maybe, but I think he knocked his own wind out of him.
He is just whipping the Disco Inferno from turnbuckle to turnbuckle. A belly-to-belly suplex.
He's got him.
One, two, hit.
Oh, yowza, yowza, yowza. Disco kicked out. Kidman not have enough weight to hold him down.
Oh, big kick there. And a swing. Breaker. That could do it.
Made a mistake.
Disco Inferno moves over. One, two, and three.
Made a mistake, baby. Big mistake right there.
He'll learn from it. A lot more action coming up here on WCW Pro on TBS this morning. When we come back, the franchise player, the Stinger, is in action. And more news about Nitro in a moment.
Athlete, but the Taskmaster bent on destroying Hulkamania, bent on ruling WCW, and right here giving you just a little example of what he's all about. There's no finesse here, my friend. There is nothing like that. One quick note about Dion and Emmett and all the guys that were out here with the girls a while ago when we were talking about Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. I tell you, Keith Jackson once said, them boys down in the trenches are called the Big Uglies. And we're talking about McMichaels and Kevin Green. And the Big Uglies are going to come to play against the Fancy Pantsers, if you will, at the Great American Bash.
One, two, over.
It was over before it started.
Yeah, it was over when they signed the contract, as a matter of fact, I do believe.
Yeah, well, that's before it started.
Alex Wright. We are back on Saturday night, and we are coming to you as hot as we can as we head into WCW's Monday Nitro, coming up this Monday live and for 2 hours. But here's a youngster from Nuremberg, Germany, that is really a sensation. We'll talk more about him, but right now we go back to David Pinter. Here comes the U.S. Heavyweight Champ.
His opponent, formerly from Cuba, now resided in Mexico City, the WCW United States Heavyweight Champion, Conan!
Here's the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Conan Dream, and I tell you, you're talking about a man who is quite a sensation as well. Internationally, Conan is.
Well, you get the whole spectrum here. We got Nuremberg, Germany against Mexico by way of Cuba, and the bottom line now is these two great athletes are ready to get it on right here on Saturday night. And I tell you what, Alex Wright, so much speed, youth, and at an early, early age, he learned to battle with the big boys play. See what Conan's got for him.
No question about it. We talked about WCW Monday Nitro Live, 8 o'clock Eastern Time. You got to see this one. We got some big title matches coming up that we'll talk about a little bit later. The Giant and Ice Train, Luger and Sting against the Steiner Brothers. A lot going on, and of course, it's the big event coming up in the month of June, as we head in the month of June here. And of course, that is the Great American Bash. Oh. Alex Wright cartwheeling out of it, at least attempting to. Arm drag takedown, and that was nicely done.
Well, he come out, he nipped up, did a little cartwheel, if you will. Then grabbed his arm, brought him over, got that wrist. Yeah, he got that wrist. Really a lot of pain right there. on that forearm and wrist and trying to really just break that thing back. Not a code red, if you will, but the Wonder Kid knows what he's doing.
Vance, as we head to the Great American Bash, there's a lot going on, a lot of animosity, and of course, a lot of talk about the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Look at Conan, if you will, arm drag takedown.
Whoa!
Ducking low that time, Alex. Right!
Oh, baby!
Backflipped it. Whoa. That worked, though, I tell you. It was a good one. Conan back up. Hip tosses him down.
Well, they both had the same idea. Nice nip up. There you go. Nip and tuck. Nip and tuck.
Great exchange by these men. But let's talk for a second. The Macho Man cannot wrestle on television.
Right.
Now, we have told him, I do understand WCW officials have said, if you want to come to the arena and you want to watch, that's cool. But you can't get in the ring. He has said, if I come to the arena, I'm going to be dressed and I'm going to wrestle.
Yes.
So each and every television taping we have security outside to lock him out to make sure he can't get in.
Well, the Nature Boy Ric Flair took him over the edge. I mean, he took, when you talk about the woman and the money and women and Elizabeth and everything that was drugging through the street for the Macho Man, Randy Savage, he got to be feeling really poorly right now. And then been cuffed, locked out so many occasions, and now wanting to get, he just wants to get it done with the Nature Boy Ric Flair. But what he did last Saturday night, as I said, I will not condone hitting an official like he did. So yes, beefed up security. They're all here. And the Macho Man running around trying to get in.
Conan, a predicament here at the hands of Alex Wright. Conan to face El Gato, international star for the U.S. title.
El Gato.
El Gato coming up at the Great American Bash. However, an upset here by Alex Wright, and the youngster from Nuremberg would go into the Great American Bash as the U.S. heavyweight champion. Single leg pickup now. Alex Wright content with keeping him off his feet.
Right? Yeah, he is. And every time this young man is on television, if you will, the whole continent, if you will, of Germany watches the young Alex Wright. He was sent here so young to learn his trade, and boy, did he learn that trade well. He's been in there with the likes of the Nature Boy Ric Flair, with the Iron Anderson. He's been in there against the Giants. He's been there against the United States heavyweight champion Conan. A lot of ability, this young man. A long way to go for him. Learning every day right here on Saturday night.
A good look at this capacity crowd on hand for WCW Saturday night. Good to have you with us, and we certainly hope that you will join us tomorrow night for the main event at 6:05 Eastern time. Into the ropes. Whoa. Tumbling in. Whoa, my goodness.
Well, he popped up so quick with that. With that clothesline, he just leveled him. He did a forward roll, come up in a clothesline, and I'm sure that Alex Wright was looking down at the ground at the forward roll and didn't look up. All of a sudden, he got him under the chin, and right on the kneecap.
How about that? And a form of the DDT. That was a drop kick, as you said, Dream, on the kneecap. That took a lot of skill to do that. One, two.
Whoa. The kid kicked out.
I mean, you really got to time your jump to get a drop kick on the kneecap.
That's true. That's true. Remember, in the hotel room, I tried to teach you that.
Yeah, you didn't.
And that's about as high as you could get right there.
Oh, look at that. Spin wheel kick. On the kneecap.
Spin wheel kick.
Yes. I mean, it was quite a skill level for someone who can jump. A pickup, and down he goes. And one, two. Alex didn't hook a far leg that time, and it cost him, I think.
Yeah, there was no good cover there. Got him in a position where he was trying to put him away. But when you do something, you got a guy that's on his back anytime. You got to grab a leg and hook him up. I don't care if it's early in the match or late. Go ahead and do it. Don't waste a pin.
A back elbow was on target that time. And Alex Wright sends the man back to the corner. Shoulder block again. Alex Wright scoop slam. Put him down.
Well, he sure did, too, and he was close to the corner right here. I think he's going for a high-risk maneuver. Yeah, there he goes up outside.
And I think he's wasting a lot of precious time here. There he goes.
Got
him. Big splash. Got him one. Got him two. And did not get the three count yet.
Man, that was close.
And disappointed is Alex Wright. The youngster thought he was the U.S. champ there, but that would not be the case. Snap suplex over.
Once again now. Don't make a mistake, kid. I tell you, you've been up once when you go up twice.
That's right.
Bad things happen sometimes. Got him again. Hook the leg, cover him.
One, two, and Conan escapes again. Tell you what, Conan, such determination.
Yeah, he's no quitting, Conan. What a great athlete he is. I guarantee you. Got him.
Conan rolls him up. Wait a minute. Who was
the champion?
There?
The winner of the match, the United States heavyweight champion, Conan.
Well, the pin.
But the referee made a quick. He made a quick call, brother. Good match. Want to see this one again? I guarantee you. Another matchup for these two coming up.
Conan, Alex Wright congratulating each other. It was a great matchup. Still more to come here on WCW Saturday night. Stay with us here on TBS. And Chris Benoit, two men who certainly are top contenders for the WCW Cruiserweight Championship, won on this program a week ago and held by none other than the Iceman, Dean Malenko.
You know, you look at Dean Malenko, and really, he is an Iceman. He has no emotion, no expression, but he knows what to do in there. Benoit's a lot like that.
Yes, he is.
But Salsa Lips here, he's more energetic. He shows it when he's mad and upset and frustrated. Then again, you've never had Mrs. Guerrero's chili.
Back, they go to the corner. Please stop about the Guerreros and chili and whatever. You can't deny that Eddie Guerrero, one of the greats in our sport. Backslide. Benoit gets a two. Eddie over the top. One, two, no. Oh, my.
Back in.
Way to the ring. Here's a young man who's quite a sensation. Not the biggest guy in the world, but maybe one of the quickest we've ever seen, Green.
Well, he is so quick and possesses a lot of skills, and that's true, but he's going to be in there, I guarantee you, with a man that knows so much about mat wrestling, love Steven Regal, who slapped Stinger at a recent signing. That thing is a great American Bash on pay-per-view coming up, but the whole world, Tony, is talking about our colleague. When you talk about Bobby the Brain Heenan, what he did, talk about the All-Madden team. What a great manager he was, like him or not. Bottom Stinger, what I call a franchise brother. And wow, that thing, like you say, we're going to talk to Stinger, but it's electric. Yes, it is. Did you see her come by here? Yeah, you did. You were talking. Did you see her?
Get back with the program here. Now, I tell you.
What? Who dare crack whip with the American Dream?
I'm probably the only one, actually. Okay. It's Lord Steven Regal. I want to talk for a moment about the Macho Man Randy Savage. The Macho Man Randy Savage,
yes,
has been barred from wrestling on television. However, he is able to come to the Baltimore Arena as the coach, as the advisor to Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green. As a matter of fact, I've been told by head of security Doug Dillinger, look at this.
Got him.
Down one, two. Billy Kidman almost got a quick win. Well, but the Macho Man tried to get it. Tried to get in here tonight to wrestle, but they would not allow him to wrestle on TV.
Well, Doug has spent the last few months keeping him out of the arena right here.
Oh, yeah. Kidman showing his superiority as far as quickness is concerned.
Yeah, but
Regal's showing his superiority as ring savvy is concerned.
Yeah, he got ruffled just enough, but I'll tell you, Kidman really took it to him. Some fine moves right there. Double underarm hook right over here to the suplex. Turned him on now.
One, two, three, beating.
Wow.
Well, Regal just ran right over him.
Well, he knew he had to. He was getting ready to get beat.
Billy Kidman tried his quickness, and it was looking pretty good at the beginning, but Regal got his dander up, and Billy Kidman paid the price for it here on Saturday night.
He got his what?
Two really
his dander. Dander. D-A-N-D-A-N-D-A-N-D-A-N.
Forget it. Dander.
His dander up. Okay.
Got his dander.
Regal's going to get a chance to talk here in a minute, so we'll just talk over him right now. We'll get a chance to talk with Mean Gene Okerlund here.
All right.
Well, the Great American Bash next Sunday. Regal and Sting, USA, Great Britain. It should be a classic.
Well, right here, got the double underarm hook right over here to a suplex after Billy Kidman really took it to him, but Regal got his dander up, if you will, and gets a 1-2-3 right here on Saturday night.
We go to Mean Gene Okerlund on TBS.
We have seen him in action. I suspect we're going to... Larry Zbysko, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and gentlemen, our main event pits the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit against Brad Armstrong. These two cruiserweights fighting it out for the title now held by Dean Malenko. They want a shot at him.
Well, once you become a champion, you get a belt around your waist. Big target also appears on your back. Everybody wants a shot at you. That's the key to success, fame, and fortune, and beautiful deaf mutes.
Well, these two guys right here, they're veteran, they're seasoned. They know what needs to be done to get a victory here on the pro. Brad Armstrong, both of them possessing so much speed, and they have the knowledge of mat wrestling, and it just who wants it the most, and we're going to find out right here on the pro. Headlock, trying to maintain him right here at the get-go.
The Canadian crippler, a 10-year professional wrestler now, 5'11" and 240 pounds. Nice movement there by Armstrong. Beautiful drop kick, and the crippler leaves the ring. Smart move on his part.
Yeah, left it quickly, too. I mean, Armstrong, he's chasing him out there. Yeah, that could be stupid sometimes to get overzealous.
Well, he made a mistake. You're right.
Yes, a stupid mistake.
Yes. I knew you were getting there, and that was really what happened.
It is unfortunate, Larry, that it has to be characterized by you in the pejorative, but nonetheless, oh, look at that drop toe hold. It was a mistake. And Armstrong floats over into a headlock right on the mat.
Brad won right back to the headlock, and maintaining that ride is important. The longer he can keep the pressure on him and weigh him out down there and cut the blood off to the carotid artery up there, using that headlock, he stands a better chance of winning.
Now you tell me, Cruz.
And even worse, if the blood is cut off to the carotid artery.
Watch out. Tried to back him in right here.
The shove off there of Armstrong. Armstrong goes between the legs of the Canadian crippler and Zagiri. And at 360s, Benoit. Man, Armstrong has got Benoit's number.
Well, he's got a basic headlock. I mean, that's wrestling 101. It's effective, but it's basic. And Armstrong not taking any chances, really not doing anything.